guys, welcome to another video. Now, as you can see, we are in Minecraft, and, well, basically, this is a maze with a creature in it. So basically, I'll give a quick rundown. Green beds are the save points. There are going to be gray doors, which are your hiding spots, and signs giving you clues on what to do. And this is an iron door, and you need this to get in. That chest over there is also all the accessories used in here. Well, except for these two eggs, and this, and this. But all these I used. I even used the emeralds for a chest. I didn't use the torch, though. So we just put that in, and then... it's our only way in. That's the gimmick, so you can't get back out. And it has to do the back door. See, hide, and then...
Yo! See, I told you! Hey, buddy!
There's a spawn point if you die.
No!
No! I placed the lantern on accident. Damn it. Give me it. How long does it take to break a lantern? Or just pick it up? Come on. Thank you. It's surrounding the area. See? This is actually kind of scary. See, I told you the hiding spots work. I know where everything is. So the gimmick is you have to get all the emeralds, then you have to use this to get out. I'm not gonna really pick it. Backdoor key, as you can see. So, as you can see, there's like a hiding spot right behind me. So,
yo, no, stand in there.
Yeah, I'm freaking out. It's trying to get in. You lost me. You're nothing right here. Gotta wait for it to walk away. It's camping the door. Go for it!
No!
Yo! The front door is like this way, I'm pretty sure. I'm pretty sure he can't go through the narrow hallway.
That came in clutch!
Why is this camping the door? Yo, that was so clutch! That was fun! Yo, that came in clutch, dude. I freaking sniped him. Turns out he can go through narrow hallways. Yeah, Jesus, man. This thing is terrifying. See, these things run so fast! There's also no way to get around. Like, he's... you have to go through the maze if you want to get back around. But there's no way back in, so you have to go around if you want to play again. And this time, you have a way to get out. So, you know, you could just have fun. I'll show you a nice little map layout of the maze. So this is the layout. It's a very small maze, but you know, this is pretty much the layout. Basic. Now, this is where you're supposed to first, this is like the Velociraptor little spot, you know, it just relaxes. Here it is right here, the monster. I want to make it bigger, but I'll do it soon enough. Like, once it's gone through the maze, it brings down the door. Like, then there's, you know, there's the escape, but then there's, like, you know, so there's more maze. Maybe. Maybe that's, like, phase one of the maze. Like, this is the first part of the maze. Then we add even more maze. So I looked at a couple pictures of mazes, and I thought, what to do? I should have dead ends, twists and turns, and, you know, little extra hallways to mislead. Like, this is a dead end. You know, dead ends. You have to find a key. Like, you have to go around this area. There's hiding spots, not many. I just used the little loops and turned them into spots where you can hide. And it worked first. You saw that it just left me alone. And there's an option to pretty much shout at your face, hi, here. There's this. There's a bed for, like, spawn points. There's, like, a bed for, like, spawn points. Obviously. That's what beds are for, so when you die from the Velociraptor, you join back in. It's kind of, you know, I might add more since it's big, but you know, I kind of know the layout. Obviously, I'm the one who made the maze. I mean, I have way more space going down here, and I have a lot more space going here too, so I can make it bigger from there. I can make a mini maze. Mini maze, like a little tiny maze. Like, this is like more of a medium type of maze. Isn't huge, it isn't that dynamic. You know, basically, you know where everything is. That's why I might set it to Adventure, because I'm pretty sure Adventure mode, if I'm correct, you can't break blocks so easily. Like, I'm trying to break dirt in Adventure mode. You can't break anything. You have to literally do it with the tools, I think. It's a nice little dynamic. Yeah, so, but survival, I think, is the best way to go. I think no matter the survival, I might have to get rid of these Triceratops. I'm not gonna kill them, but I might, you know, train them or whatever. I reckon if you want to use this dinosaur, you have to do it in DLC only. But you could probably make a maze with like a zombie or some other thing. But I mean, it won't be as like, it probably won't be as fast since no mobs are in the regular game aren't really that fast. Like, you saw that thing charged at me when it was in its peripheral. It's, you know, it's fun. It's just a nice little game. Mini maze, or what was that? You know, you get emeralds for, like, money or whatever. That's what they're used for. It's just, I think it's kind of cool. You could probably use a Ravager, but you'd have to make it a big. You could, like, I think the best thing you would probably use for this is like a mini little zombie, because mini zombies are fast. Or spiders, but they could just crawl up. Enderman can teleport out of here, so it's kind of difficult what you want to use for like regular Minecraft. But you can do it. This is just nice little simple maze. Slow fun with the task. Like, I could do this whole maze. I could do it with survival and creative without flying. I know exactly where it is. I mean, the twists and turns aren't that good. I mean, this is basically your pathway to do it. But if you didn't create it, and that kind of, and when that velociraptor bit through the door, that was so lucky. Like, this is the thing I'm doing. Now, imagine if I put two raptors and the hiding spots have each raptor in there. So, have raptors in there, since you put the hiding spot. But for a hiding spot, you add one more raptor to chase you, and you have to get out there too. I think this is best two player. Because, I don't know, maybe two player for like hard mode, so somebody, you know, and you can't save, you can't have a spawn point, you're gonna spawn, like, outside again, so you have to find your way all over, so it's hold for the beds, it's just to save your progress. Now once I make this bigger, that's when the whole thing is gonna... That's when everything's gonna come together. Alright, now let's spawn a villager. Let's just spawn one random villager. Like our little mouse trap, and that will spawn two villagers. Whoop. Uh-oh. Uh-oh. I'm gonna spawn one right here. They know how to use doors. Wow. It's not eating the villagers, it's a pacifist. Why is it trying to kill me then? Why? Park visitors. Oh. Beat. It'll attack this kid, definitely. Okay, come on. See? We might have to get rid of the villagers. We might have to get rid of this egg. And I'm sorry, buddy, but I might have to do something for you. Boom. Bing. Boom. Why does it sound like a guy? It sounds like the farm villagers. Okay, that's weird. This is basically what it would look like. Like, it's speeding through for some reason. Which is like, why? Here, look. Well, but are not that good at running away. Like, come on. What is this? Dude, these lobsters are trash, man. Killing people. Alright, I'm done.